Hey guys, it's Wednesday. You know what that is, comic book day. So I'm heading over to my local shop. It's one that's close to my work. And go pick up some comic books. Today's a good day. The new DC stuff is out. So let's travel to the comic store and I'll show you what I get after. Talk to you in a bit.
Made me feel right. Wish the bliss could never take flight. Sitting back with this mic in my hand, spitting hot shit, trying to see grand. Imprinted on my mind every minute. Make my plans and you always in it, y'all. Such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. And even though we both fly, give each other space and not the evil eye. Acting like grown-ups, don't even try to hide, cause the spot blown up. Girlfriend telling you she wanna see. I say I don't know, but you say gladly. And when we both do head, we go on and on and on and on and on and sweeter than Ben and Jerry. Can I rhyme? Well, you know I guess mine. Sitting round in my abstract car. This abstract thing going abstract far, yeah. Such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Check it, yeah, look at check me. It, look at y'all, check it, look at me. Yeah, yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Look at y'all, check it, look at me. Check it, look at y'all, check it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, it's such a vibrant thing. Vibrant, Getting back to my MC status. All the willy that I kick make the other niggas maddest. Moving through your town of situation. Shorty thought she subtle, but she really was blatant when she shook a thing and violated.
So I just got out of the comic store. Found a couple things that I wasn't expecting to find. So I had to pick them up. Got another Hydra Soldier. Oh, make that two Hydra Soldiers. One variant, one regular. Still building my army. Comic book wise, got this one, been anticipating this one. It's the first one of the new 52, Justice League number 1. Flashpoint number 5. Finally get to finish this off and can't wait to see what happens. Batman Arkham City number 5. Great read. X-Men Legacy 254. This is another great series that I'm really enjoying. And of course, we got Uncanny X-Force 13 and 14. Another great series I like. Iron Man 2.0 number 8. Interested to see what happens here. Future Foundation number 8. Fear Itself, Youth in Revolt 4 of 6. I'm actually really enjoying this one out of all the Fear Itself. And Amazing Spider-Man 668 part 2 of Spider Island. Can't wait to read this one too. So that's it for comics this week. It's probably going to be a lot heavier next week. Yeah, kids, for all you kids watching, read comics. It's a dying pastime. People are just picking things up online now. But having comic book in hand, it's totally different. And you appreciate it more when you have the comic books in hand and you want to keep them in good condition and whatnot. So kids, get out there, get to your local comic store, get some comics and spend a day reading rather than just hanging around playing vids all day. Just my two cents, but hope some of you take my advice. So when the San Diego Comic-Con exclusives went on sale at MattyCollector.com, I was away in the States on vacation. As all of you know, that's when we went down to Valley Fair. So I had a friend of mine locally make the orders for me as he was picking up stuff for himself. So he came by, dropped off the stuff, and let me show you what he brought. First off, we got the Green Lantern Movie Masters Kilowog. Pretty nice figure. Hopefully it's more articulated than it looks, but pretty good detail in them. Then from the Masters of the Universe Classics, we've got Captain Glenn, or Queen Marlena. From Young Justice, the DC Universe, we got Superboy in the cloning chamber. And lastly, I had to back up a little bit for this. It's a pretty big box. DC Universe Classics SDCC exclusive Swamp Thing. I can't wait to open this guy up. And today, through the help of another collector, I was able to find these. Been looking everywhere in the States for them. Couldn't find them. And I finally got a couple. So I need about 6 more to go, or at least 4. And that is the Sentinel, Marvel Universe. So I got 1 and 2. Awesome. Can't wait to put these in some ACBAs. So I got another, or shall we say my first Transformer Collector Club exclusive sideburn. I got this from a local collector, a friend of mine, Ben, otherwise known as TF Benzo on YouTube, or just Benzo on the Cybertron and TFW boards. I am a club member myself, but I say this is my first, and that's because the shipment for the sideburns coming to Canada, they haven't arrived yet. There's numerous of us here in Winnipeg that haven't gotten theirs yet. I'm still waiting. I've emailed the club about it, and they said it should be here, if it's not here by the 9th, to give them a shout back. So this is my second one, and I got a second one mainly because I don't see myself getting a Henke Wild Rider anytime in the near future. So I really want to use my Fans Project Shadow Scythe armor on this guy. I think it'll look really, really good, actually. And yeah, I do have the Botcon Shattered Glass hot rod, but I don't want to break up my box set for a third-party add-on. So I'm going to use this, and when I do get to that, I'll show you guys and show you how it looks. I think it's going to look great. Let me know your thoughts and opinions on if you think it'll look good with it. So for you that have been following me on Twitter, you know, on the weekend, I had a really rough go finding this game, Madden 2012 for the PS3. I looked everywhere. I was stupid. I didn't pre-order it. I looked everywhere. Walmart's, Best Buy, Future Shops, Zellers, Superstore, and I couldn't find one. And I even went on Twitter and complained, because I was at Walmart one day, and a lady approached me and asked if she could help me, and I said, yeah, you guys happen to have the Madden 2012 for PS3? And she's like, oh, sorry, we're all sold out, but we have it on Xbox if you like. So I looked at her, and I know she was just trying to help, but I looked at her with the dumbfounded face and snarkily asked her if that Xbox game would work on my PS3, and walked away. Normally I'm not a prick, but I was just so frustrated not finding this game. But the next day after that incident, I went to EB Games, which is sort of like GameStop. Didn't really want to go there, but they ended up having multiple copies. So basically every day since I got this, I've been kind of on it, and which is why we're having a really, really late Monday musings. So I apologize. You know how it is when you get into something, it's hard to put down and it's hard to focus on other things. But just got home from work. I want to go play this game, but figure I better do this video first. So as far as opening parties, I've done a couple opening parties last week. I'll try and get a couple more this week. I probably maybe only one this week, and I'll continue on the next week. I will give you guys a heads up that it will be Marvel related, whether it's Legends or Universe or more Marvel selects. We'll see, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be Marvel Universe, spoiler. And secondly, I was planning on doing a Monday Musing C4, like dedicate my next Monday Musings to C4, which is our Comic-Con. I won't be able to do that this week, possibly next week. I don't have time to go down to the promotions base of operations. So I will possibly be conducting an interview. It's not 100% yet, but I definitely will be showing montages of past Comic-Con pictures and vids, and I'll post links to the website. I'll talk about the guests and whatnot. That's all going to be on my next Monday Musings. Plus, I might have a pretty large haul also. So that's for next week. And yeah, I think I'm going to cut it short this week. Got to go play some Madden. So until next time, Evil Car out.